Welcome back for two more examples. We want to find each sum expressed using summation notation, also called sigma notation. So we'll be using this formula here to generate the terms, which will then sum using the values of I, where I starts at the value of 1, increases by 1 until it reaches the value of 4. So to generate the first term in the series, I is equal to 1, so we'd have negative 1 to the first times 3 times 1. For the second term, I is equal to 2, so we'd have negative 1 to the second, and then times 3 times 2. For the third term, I is equal to 3, so we would have negative 1 to the third times 3 times 3. And then finally, for the last term in the sequence, when I is equal to 4, the upper bound of summation, we would have negative 1 to the fourth times 3 times 4. Now we'll evaluate each of these and then find the sum. Well, here we would have negative 1 times 3, that's negative 3, plus here we have negative 1 squared, so that's positive 1 times 6, which is 6, plus negative 1 to the third is negative 1, so we have negative 1 times 9, that's negative 9. And the last term is negative 1 to the fourth, that's positive 1 times 12, so this is equal to 12. Well, since negative 3 plus negative 9 is negative 12, negative 12 plus 12 is 0 plus 6, so our sum is 6. Let's take a look at our second example. Notice how now the index is n, and the values of n start at 0, increase by 1, until we reach the value of 3. So when n is equal to 0, the first term would be 0 factorial divided by 4. The second term is when n equals 1, so we'd have 1 factorial divided by 4, plus for the third term, n is equal to 2, so we have 2 factorial divided by 4. And then finally, when n is 3, we have our last term, which would be 3 factorial divided by 4. Well, by definition, 0 factorial is equal to 1, so we have 1 fourth plus 1 factorial is also equal to 1, so that'd be 1 fourth. 2 factorial is equal to 2 times 1, so this will be 2 fourths. I know this does simplify, but if we want to find this sum, we do have to have a common denominator. And then for the last term, 3 factorial is equal to 3 times 2 times 1, or 6, so this would be 6 fourths. So our sum would be, looks like, 10 fourths, which simplifies to 5 halves. I hope you found these two examples helpful.